Okay, so let us start today's session. And today being the last session, what I've planned is that I'm going to take up the queries which were asked. I'm going to take up the topics which are still pending. And I'm going to have a conversation with you at the end so that in case you have any other question left in your mind, that can be sorted. Okay, so today I will be definitely taking three aspects. One, as Mrs. Nagarajan has mentioned last time about pranayam and about the knee pain. So we will be taking that into consideration. And there was also a question from someone regarding the plantar fasciitis. Okay, so that problem I'm going to tackle again. So these three things I'm going to focus on. So it is very, very important that first of all, considering that from Monday onwards, you are going to start going to the office, you have to take care of yourself. That is very important. Now, how do we do that? Is there some problem? Asanas to be done every day. Okay.
They are posting on the chat.
Okay, okay.
What are the asanas and the breathing techniques to be done?
Yeah, we will do that. Okay. So, first thing is that immunity is something which cannot come just in one day, right? Immunity is something which has to be imbibed through your lifestyle, through your food habits, through exercise, so that you have strong immunity within. Few things which I'm again going to mention. Today's session is going to be more of tips, answering your questions, doing something in combination with that. Drinking a lot of warm water is very, very important. You also must be going through the Ministry of Ayush guidelines, which they are providing on a very regular basis. And they are also emphasizing on drinking a lot of warm water. Now, considering in India, it is very warm, it is hot. Try at least not to drink refrigerated water. Okay, try not to drink refrigerated water. And whenever you can, just have some sips of warm water so that you keep your system clean and keep the germs away from the system. Second is that you are supposed to have few things in your daily diet. For example, having hot milk with turmeric mixed into it. So you are supposed to have that on a daily basis. Even small quantity of milk is also fine, but haldi or turmeric has to be mixed with milk, not with water. With water, that significant ingredients which are going to come to your system, that's not going to enter. So it is important that you are supposed to have milk with turmeric, have some lime water, have some coconut water. Keep yourself hydrated, that is important. Do not keep your throat dry for a long period of time. If you're feeling thirsty, have water then and there. And also the intake of some important spices, which we get it in India, like jeera, that is very good. Jeera water is very good. So basic things important, having your meals at the right time, sleeping for at least 7 to 8 hours is very, again, very important so that the system is very healthy internally. And keeping yourself away from stress, negativities. Also, continue with your practice of asanas, pranayams, meditation, relaxation. Some form of exercise is very, very important. So please do that. And now we are going to start with the first segment, which will be going to be on pranayam. Now for pranayam, it is very important that you must understand that the energy which we are getting, it is through the prana, that is the bioenergy. And it is very important that you take care of this bioenergy on a daily basis. We have been doing some techniques, and in your regular sessions in your respective cities, you must be also learning various kinds of pranayams. So I'm going to give you the crux of pranayam. I'm going to explain to you that how you're supposed to take care of your breath. Understand that the mind and the breath, they are correlated with each other. If you are happy, you check your breathing, it is different. If you're sad, again you check your breathing, it is different. If you're excited, check your breathing, it is different. Running, sitting, meditating, every time the breathing is different. Now you must understand the basic thing that the number of breaths is correlated to the number of years you are going to live. For example, if you just watch a rabbit breathing, in case you have watched a rabbit breathing, he breathes very, very fast. Very fast breathing. A dog, again, fast breathing. And what is the lifespan of a rabbit, of a dog? Just a few years. But if we now take, for example, a tortoise, elephant, they take very long and deep breaths. Hardly, say, around, you know, one breath in a minute. And now compare their lifespan. It's really long, right? So it is important that the number of breaths you are going to take, you're supposed to have normal, deep breaths. Try not to take shallow breaths. Whenever we are breathing, we're supposed to breathe in through the nose. And why we are breathing in through the nose? It is very, very important. You must understand the importance of breathing through the nose. When the air enters the system, it is cool. The air is cool. And when it enters the nose, the temperature changes and it becomes warm. And that form of air is actually required for the body. If we are directly breathing from the mouth, then we are taking the cool air. It is entering in the cool form, which is not good for the body. So you should always breathe through the nose. That is important. Also in the nose, the inside the nostrils, we have those hair follicles, which helps in filtering the air. So again, all those things are very scientifically made, and we are supposed to follow the basics. If we follow the basics, we remain healthy. So it is important that we breathe through the nose. Now, as soon as the air enters your nostril, it first of all reaches your clavicular muscles. Now, where are the clavicular muscles? The muscles here around the collarbone, these are the clavicular muscles. And then slowly and gently, it enters the intercostal muscles. Intercostal muscles are the lungs. We have the ribs on the lungs, okay? For example, so there are 12 ribs. So one rib, other rib. In between, we have a muscle, which is called as the intercostal muscle. So when we are expanding our chest, the intercostal muscles expands. And when we are contracting, it contracts. And then we have the diaphragm here. We have the abdominal muscle below that. Now, understand these three important muscles. For that, everyone, please sit straight. Sit straight. Close your eyes. And just relax with some normal breaths. Feel the breath entering your system as you inhale. And coming out from your nostrils as you exhale. Now, when you inhale, feel the air reaching your clavicular muscles, the collarbone, going inside the lungs, intercostal muscles, and then reaching your abdominal muscles. And then slowly and gently, it is the reverse process. Now let us start with equal breathing. That means the number of counts you inhale is equal to the number of counts you exhale. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. 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 Relax. Keep your eyes closed and just relax. Never immediately open your eyes after doing any breathing technique or any meditation technique. Just be with yourself, be with the experience, feel your spine, feel the energy. And now very gently you may open up your eyes. Now let us feel our clavicular muscles. So for that, place your four fingers on your collarbone and place the thumb at the back. Very good. Chin in front, look in front, close your eyes. Just to feel your clavicular muscles, we will be chanting the sound of Om so that you feel the clavicular muscles expanding and contracting. Just inhale deeply. Now that you felt your clavicular muscles, which are very subtle muscles, we start with the clavicular breathing. Consciously try to inhale through your clavicular muscles and expand the clavicular muscles as you inhale. As you exhale, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Keep your eyes closed. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Slowly relax your hands. Keep your eyes closed. Feel your clavicular muscles breathing naturally. And now gently you may open up your eyes. Now we are going to use our intercostal muscles. For that, keep your four fingers straight and place them on the intercostal muscles. And the thumb is at the back side. Keep your back straight. Start. Inhale, expand. Expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Keep your eyes closed. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. Now relax, get your hands down, keep your eyes closed. Feel your intercostal muscles still breathing. Okay, now what we're supposed to do is the last set of muscles, that is the abdominal muscles. For that, you may just keep your right hand on your abdomen, your belly area. Left hand is relaxed. Shoulders are relaxed. As you inhale, try to expand the abdominal area as a balloon. It should come up. As you exhale, it should squeeze in. Start. Inhale, expand, expand. Exhale, contract, contract. 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 Now slowly relax. Relax your hand. Keep your eyes closed. Now that you have understood the three set of muscles, starting from your clavicular, then intercostal, then abdominal muscles, we are now going to start with yogic breathing, where we are supposed to use all these three set of muscles. So keep your back straight, be completely relaxed, eyes are closed. Inhale, take a deep full breath through your nose, clavicular, intercostal, abdomen, and then reverse, abdomen, intercostal, clavicular, out from the nose. Continue with this process of deep breaths, yogic breathing, three rounds. Try to do effortless breathing. The more you are relaxed, the better you will be able to breathe. And once you have completed your breathing, then you may just relax. And gently you may open up your eyes. So you have understood the three important set of muscles which we are supposed to use while we breathe in, while we breathe out. When we are feeling very, very low in energy, at that time, start with abdominal breathing, belly breathing. It is very, very effective. For example, you have just been through a long illness and you feel lethargic, you feel low. You should breathe through your belly. So just keep your right hand on your belly area. Breathe in, breathe out. 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 Continue. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. And then relax. I think someone has done something on the screen. Okay. So belly breathing is a very, very effective breathing. And in case you have seen a child sleeping, you know, the child is still using the correct way of breathing. If you see a child breathing, the tummy going up, down, up, down, up, down. So that is the right way of breathing. So try to, again, imbibe in case we are not breathing in the correct way. Start breathing in the correct way. Only if you're breathing in the correct way, you are going to be away from many, many problems, many, many illness. One question which I just read in the chat was the chanting of the Om. Chanting of Om, how you're supposed to chant. Now, as we all are aware that Om has three syllables. A, U, M, A, U, M. So there are three ways of chanting Om. One is that O is long and then you just end with M. O long, ending with M. O and M equal. And then O short, M longer. Okay? So let's just try chanting this three times, three different ways. Keep yourself comfortable. Close your eyes. First is O is long, ending with M. Second, O and M equal. Third, M longer. Okay, so let us start. Inhale. Relax yourself. Now, O and M equal. Start. Inhale. Third, M longer, starting with O. Inhale. Now you may gently open up your eyes. Now when we are chanting the sound of Om, Om chant in itself is a pranayama, where we are breathing longer, also we are exhaling longer. Long exhalation, in yoga it is called as rechak. So when we are breathing long, that is rechak, we are doing a pranayama. Om is also signifying the four states of awareness. Waking stage, sleeping stage, dreaming stage, all these are the stages. To just connect it with a normal life, as a normal householder's life, people who want to be more extrovert, you can chant the sound of O longer. People who want to be within themselves, introvert, or I would say within themselves, going more towards spirituality, chanting the sound of mm longer will really help. An equal sound is going to balance both the energies. So in a small nutshell, this is what I would like to explain about the Om chant, how you're supposed to chant it. Okay. Now, any other questions related to your breathing or pranayama or any other thing? So that I can now go on to the next, that is the knee problems. Yeah. Okay. Now coming to the knee problem. Knee problem is, okay, there's a question. Breathing by stomach or chest, which is better? That is the reason I have just made you experience how you're supposed to breathe. So we have these three muscles. When you breathe, you should do complete yogic breathing, full yogic breathing, full yogic breathing. If you are using your belly to breathe, you are definitely using all the muscles as well. So it is not that we are just using this part, we are not using this part. It is a very connected, if you have seen the structure of the body, it is everything is very, very connected. So when you breathe properly, all the muscles, they become active. Okay. Now coming to the knee problem. Now what is happening nowadays is that people are having a lot of problem in the knee, and that can be related to many, many issues. Understand that knee is a hinge joint. Hinge joint, that means upper part, lower part, there is a little gap, and this is the joint. So it can be moved like this, it can be moved like this, okay? Now the problem which is coming nowadays, irrespective of the age, even in younger age, people are getting knee problems, knee pains. One, I have already discussed that if you have excess of Vayu in the body, that is also a very, very big reason and cause for having joint pains. Excess Vayu in the body, that means your metabolism is not proper, your elimination is not proper, you are having constipation problem, and that is the reason it is leading to the pain in the joints. Okay, now I will write down what you have asked in the chat. Just give me a moment to explain the knee thing first. So considering this, what you're supposed to do, few things, let me start with what you are not supposed to do. Okay. Someone mentioned that I'm not visible in the full screen. Is it? Am I not visible in the full screen? Or is it fine?
It's fine. You're visible. He has to go and click on the speaker view.
He is visible. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. The participant has to click on the speaker.
Okay. Okay. Fine. Now, if you can, so you are able to see me sitting on a chair, right? Properly. Okay. Now, just focusing here. Whenever we are sitting, we are supposed to sit like this. Sit like this. That means your feet is down, knee angle 90 degree like this. Sometimes some people have the habit of sitting like this, which is again going to give a lot of pressure to the knees. It is not advisable. You're not supposed to sit like this. Some people have the habit of sitting like this. Again, this is giving a lot of pressure to the knee part. So it is not good. Not good. This is the correct posture to sit. Okay. Second, I have already mentioned, once again, I'm just revising. Your feet parallel. Not like this, not like this, parallel to each other. So whenever you are walking, heels, toes, this is slow motion. Otherwise, normal walk, how do we walk? We just walk like this. So this is fine. You should not walk like this. Okay, you're not supposed to walk like this, but like this.
उस वाले लेसन में भी था।
early in the morning, start your day with two small slices of garlic. Garlic, lehsun, two small slices, cut it and have slowly with curd, two spoons of curd. So two slices of garlic, cut them, chop them, and curd. It is going to be terrible. I will say it was going to be terrible first day, definitely, but slowly and gradually you will feel that yes, the gases are going out of the body. You feel the stomach has become flat. Some of the people, they have a bloated stomach because it is bloated with gas. It is nothing else but bloated with gas. So please start doing this, okay? And after that, you can have that warm water. Please tell again. What should I tell again? Garlic, two slices of garlic.
How many days it has been had?
Well, make it a routine. You will find it so helpful. Make it a routine. I'm sure you are not supposed to, you will be able to take some breaks in between, but try to make it as a routine.
Okay. So it is to be had after the warm water, lukewarm water in the morning.
First have this. After that,
and then
water, so the smell will also go away. And get brushed. Okay, I couldn't see the right posture to sit. Okay, I'm showing it once again. When you are sitting on the chair, am I visible? That's the reason I was asking. Am I visible to everyone proper?
Yeah, you're visible.
Okay. You are not supposed to sit. That I'm showing first. Not supposed to sit like this. Not supposed to sit like this. You're supposed to sit like this. Always straight legs, firmly on the ground. Okay? Coming to the next one, very good acupressure tip for the knees, knee joint problems. In the hands, ring finger, middle finger, ring finger, middle finger, ring finger, middle finger, the joints, these are your knees. These are your knees. Understand? Both hands, ring finger, middle finger, joints, these are your knee joints. Okay? Whenever you get the time, start massaging the knee joints. Massage. Whenever you get the time, whenever you are aware, just in the office also, just massage. This is going to keep your knees warm, which is going to really help you out for your knee problems. Okay? Understood? Oh. Next.
Both the hands.
Yes, both the hands. Both the hands. This is my left hand. This is my right hand. Okay. Revising again. Last session, I've told about thyroid gland. Where is the thyroid gland? Next to the thumb, the soft part. This is the thyroid gland. Pressing it. How you press? Press 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Release. And that is how you are supposed to press it. Both hands. Both hands. Okay. Simultaneously, I'm taking the questions. Okay, my voice is breaking. Oh God, is it? Okay. Acupressure for the knees. These two points are your knees. So you're supposed to just massage it. Whenever you get the time, whenever you are aware, just massage it. So this way you are keeping the knees warm. Okay. So this is very simple tip, which you can do it. Also, if there is no inflammation, there is no injury in the knee, then you should use a hot water bag or, this, I will just show it to you. This is called as heating pad. This is very, very effective. You all must have heating pad at home. In case you have lower back problem, you can tie it on the lower back. When you are lying down, whenever you are sitting, whenever you are relaxing, just use it for your lower back. In case you have knee problem,
yes, my name is Ankita
Sood and I'm representing for the knee. Warmth to the knee, that is very important. Always remember that whenever you are giving warmth to any of your body part, that means the muscles which are crampled up, they relaxes and blood circulation, oxygenation is better and you feel the pain is releasing. The pain is going. Okay. Is my voice proper now? Yes?
Yeah, yeah, you are very clear.
Okay. So now that is all about the knees. Now some exercises for the knees. Okay. Now you are going to office from Monday onwards. What you can do at office also.
Ma'am, exercises to be done every day. If you have this paucity of time, what are the must do asanas that you have to do every day? Mm-hmm. Could you tell us that, please?
Yeah. First, let me complete the knee segment. Important exercises for the knee. Heating pad, what is the question? Is it hot, water pack, or just cloth? Okay. It is called as heating pad. Go to the chemist, ask for heating pad. Okay, this is not a cloth. You have the heating thing inside. This is Flamingo company. This is from India only, Flamingo. It's very effective. It is called as orthopedic health heating belt. Orthopedic heating belt, the size is regular. Okay. And they give this cover so you can use the cover. Exercises for the knee. Okay. Some flexion exercises, some extension exercises, very, very important exercises. You can also do when you are in the office. First of all, you have to be careful throughout the day about your posture. The back has to be straight. Lift your leg up and then toes in. Lift your leg up, step one. Toes in, step two. Hold, one, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Relax. Same thing with the other leg. Up, flex, hold, and then down. 20 times each. 20 times right leg, 20 times left leg. Okay? Abhi, you have to invest some time. That is important. In case knee problem is happening, you really have to take care. So one is this. Second, people don't understand that the hip abductors, they play a very important role in case you have knee pain. And that is the reason people start limping, because of the hip abductors. For hip abductors, what you are supposed to do to strengthen up, support. Hip abductors are here. We are just stretching this part by aligning it. Slowly, you're supposed to just raise your leg little up. So you get a stretch completely on the hip abductors. And then down. So you take it up, you hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, slowly down. Repeat it at least 15 to 20 times and then the other side also. So this way you are going to work on the hip abductors, which are directly related to your knee, and it is very important that you take care of them. Simple things that the calf muscles. Here we have the calf muscles, here we have the hamstring muscles. These muscles have to be stretched, flexed. So all these muscles have to be taken care of. Now I'm coming to plantar fasciitis problem. What is that problem? Problem comes in the beta, mute karo apne aapko. The problem comes heel, this part where we have the muscles. Fasciitis muscles, when it gets disturbed, the pain in this part comes. Heel pains a lot. For this, I'm going to explain very simple, yet very effective self-care and self-treatment techniques. I hope the person who has asked is here. Yes or no? Okay. So, understand what you are supposed to do. The moment you keep your foot down, you get the pain. So what you're supposed to do is early in the morning when you are just on the bed, when you are on the bed. So your both your feet are up, right? So what you're supposed to do, my feet are visible. Is the angle okay? Yes. Showing it with one foot so that you are able to understand, okay? Right on the bed. Resting your feet on the bed, you're supposed to curl your toes in such a way that you shrink the bed sheet. Okay? So, with the toes, curl your toes and relax. So, what is happening is, with this curling, when we are taking the bed sheet into our toes, we are working on those fine intrinsic muscles to strengthen up. So repeat this at least 10 to 20 times with both your feet. Everyone should do it right on the bed. It is very, very good for the muscles. Okay. So one, understood. Two, stretching your toes. That is again very important. So what you're supposed to do is stretch your toes yourself. Stretch. So just turn your toes towards your ankles and stretch them nicely. And then relax. Okay, again repeat it 10 times. In case it is acute, then you might have problem which is giving you some swelling or some inflammation. So for that, you are supposed to give cold compression. Now, what is needed is cold compression. So you also get these ice packs, chemist, you will get ice packs. So just put it in on the affected area, put it here. Keep the ice pack for 10 minutes and then relax. Okay, that is very important in case it is acute. Last is, you get some rollers like this. In case this is not there, everyone is having balan at home. Balan, yes. So we can have one balan for all these acupressure techniques. Okay, now what you're supposed to do is, is my foot visible? Yes.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Visible.
So what you are supposed to do is just roll. Both legs. You can also sit. So this rolling is going to again give acupressure, especially to the intrinsic muscles. Also, when you are using the roller, you are giving pressure to the entire sole. That means acupressure from your head to toe. Everything you are covering. So this is very good. You can keep some roller, you know, under your office chair and you can do that. You also get heat. If it is very, very acute, you also get heel protection. You know, you get those heel cushions. You can buy it from the market, heel cushions. Very, very easy. You can just put it, you know, on the heel, the sole, and it's very, very effective. So you don't get that problem, that pain. Okay?
And my problem, my problem is basically on the this rear portion of the heel. A bone has come out. So here when I walk, the nerve rubs against the bone and that gives us the pain.
Yeah.
This is much of an issue. But here this portion, this behind portion.
So you must understand that all these are interrelated. They are all connected. So you just start with what I have taught you today and you can get back to me on my yoga page. I hope you are connected on my yoga page on Facebook. I keep on doing some Facebook lives also. So you can stay connected there. And very soon, when I'm back in India, we can meet in person, especially Mumbai headquarters. Yes. So that can also be done. Right. Yes. And so today I just wanted, being the last session, I wanted to cover up all your queries. So I think Mrs. Nagarajan, good for pranayam and knee, perfect. And Mr. Nigam, good for your...
Angita, really.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, perfect. Any more
One
questions?
More thing. Angita, yeah. I wanted to tell you, I've been doing that leg up asana against the wall and other ones which you told me. I do find a lot of difference in the way my legs have been responding in this last 10 days or so, you know, since the time you taught those exercises. It is a definite relief to the feet. I have found a definite change. Thank you so much.
Ankita, there was one query from Mr. Manoj Mathur. Please suggest some tips for tennis elbow.
Tennis elbow. Okay. Now for tennis elbow, what you are supposed to do is just stretch your arm in front and slowly drop your hand. Just drop. Once you have dropped, fist. The moment you make a fist, immediately it goes to your tennis elbow problem, these muscles. Tight, relax, and up. Okay, repeat. Arm is in front, Bina. Arm is in front. Yes. So here we do it. Start, drop, thumb in, fist, tight. Getting pressure, hold, relax. You can repeat it, both your arms, 5 to 10 times. Only after doing it 2 times, you feel the difference, okay? Okay? Any other question?
Somebody is asking for golfer elbow.
Sorry?
Golfer elbow. Golf.
Golf?
Golf. Same.
Same. You play tennis or you play golf. The muscles are the same.
And for frozen shoulder?
Okay, frozen shoulder. Frozen shoulder is again becoming a lot of
you know, a lot of them are suffering from frozen shoulder. One thing which is like a secret, in case you have frozen shoulder, after 6 months, it's going to go away on its own. You do something, you don't do anything. It's going to go away. So what research has shown, people when they start, they keep on, you know, asking and doing some things here, there. Once 6 months pass, they say, yeah, it has become fine now. But naturally. But important thing is, this doing some shoulder exercises, very, very difficult to even raise the arm up for frozen shoulder. But slowly, just jahan tak ho raha hai wahan tak. Itna bhi mushkil hota hai. Okay, for frozen shoulder. But slowly, ye karna. Ya phir. Wall pe. So you are just moving your fingers up, stretch, and then down. Moving up, down. Okay. Yeah.
I will take two or three more queries. Somebody is asking for tight hamstring.
Tight hamstring, this which I showed you. Stretch, toe in. This is going to work on your hamstring also, calf muscles also. Same thing, you can do it lying down. So you are lying down. You raise your legs 90 degrees up. This is your body, these are your legs. Raise your legs up, toes in. This is going to give marvelous stretch. Okay? Start going to your office by cycle. Yes. It's a very good exercise.
Okay, then Hari is asking, knee is paining while climbing steps beyond second floor.
Okay. How to climb the steps? Now, for example, this is the step. Heel, toe. Okay? Heel, toe. Point number one. Point number two, if you have extreme knee pain, please use the elevator. It is better. Do not use the staircase. It is going to strain you more. Use the elevator. In case still you have to climb some stairs, do not give pressure on the affected knee. For example, right knee is paining. How are you supposed to step? Now, this is a very big step. Generally, chota hota hai, but main aapko dikhane ke liye, I'm just showing it to you. If the right knee is paining, keep the left leg first up and then coming down. If the right knee is paining, first get your right leg down. See kya ho raha hai? Left knee bend ho raha hai na? So right knee is straight. So whichever knee is paining, try not to bend that leg. Keep that leg straight. One more time. Right leg paining. Don't bend your right leg. So you are bending your left leg. And vice versa. Okay, next question.
Acute back muscle pain. Any exercise for that? Lena wants to know.
Of course, I have taught you Bhujangasana. I have taught you the counter pose. You are supposed to do that on a regular basis. Regular basis. Simple, but very effective. counter pose very important.
Any acupressure technique, ma'am, for back pain relaxation?
It is very important that you strengthen up your muscles. Hai acupressure techniques bhi, but I want you to first strengthen up the backbone muscles. The muscles have to be very very flexible. आप पहले वो करके फिर मेरे योगा पेज पे लिखो, फिर मैं आपको बताती हूँ. ठीक है? Done.
Just a moment. I'll read one more. If you have slipped this problem, whether it is advisable to do all yoga asanas?
For slip disc, then you have to be very, very specific. You are supposed to, under the guidance of the teacher, you have to do specific things related to slip disc.
Then is there any exercise for carpal tunnel syndrome?
Yes. You're supposed to just keep moving. Hands also, feet also. We have the web. Let me just show you on the feet. What is the web? The toe, we have this. These are the webs. So acupressure is just do this for both your feet, hands. So the web is clean and clear. There are no blockages.
So these were the queries.
Ma'am, just one more. If the pain is there on the feet, on the ankle, somebody says that you soak your feet in the warm water with some salt. Do I do that or shall I use the ice pack?
Do you have inflammation? Very simple.
It gets warm. This area gets very warm, and then so there is some carti something which.
You have to, for your problem, it is only cool packs. In case it is inflammation, there is swelling, there is redness, that means cooling is required. Okay, understand. You had a fall. Immediately, cooling has to be done. Immediately. Never do hot fermentation. Immediately, cooling has to be done. But now when I'm saying that you have some stiffness, some tightness, some spasm, frozen shoulders, all those things, warmth has to be given. Okay?
Ankita, if there's positive time, some of the asanas that have to be done every day, could you just say which are the asanas to be done every day?
Taadasan, Tidak Taadasan, Kati Chakrasan, TTK, you remember? TTK, Taadasan, Tidak Taadasan, Kati Chakrasan, Surya Namaskar, Paschimottanasan, Bhujangasan, Pavan Muktasan, Shavasan, office.
Thank you.
There's one last question. Any exercise for the eyes?
Yes, of course. जितने बॉडी पार्ट्स हैं सबके लिए एक्सरसाइजेस हैं, बट करना पड़ेगा. पेन अपने पास होगा, अगर नहीं है, वी हैव आवर थंब, टॉप पार्ट ऑफ द थंब और टिप ऑफ द पेन. ओके, आई एम जस्ट शोइंग इट टू यू. आई लेवल पे यू आर सपोज टू कीप द पेन और योर थंब. आई लेवल इज this. Slowly, you're supposed to just focus on the tip as slow as possible. Abhi time nahi hai, but as slow as possible, you're supposed to get the pen as close to the tip of the nose. If, for example, here you feel it has become two, then stop there. And then slowly go back. So I'm now showing it very fast just to understand. One, two, three, four, five. Center. Simple. All diagonals, all the angles. Even again, this I have also posted on my yoga page, Ankita Sood yoga page, some exercises for the eyes. Okay.
Somebody was asking whether with specs or without specs.
If it is a very big number, then if you feel comfortable with specs, okay. Otherwise, without specs. Without lenses, of course.
And one of the participants wants to know any exercise for sleeplessness.
For?
Sleeplessness.
Insomnia. Okay. Insomnia, very, very effective is Anulom Vilom Pranayam, alternate nostril breathing before going off to bed. Do Anulom Vilom Pranayam, do Brahmari Pranayam. That is very effective. Lie down on your lie down on your back when you are on the bed, fold your legs and do abdominal breathing. Go off to sleep. Also, this part has to be pressed. Okay, so I think now I have given the solutions to all of you. It is very important that you take care of yourself while at home or outside home. You're supposed to be healthy, positive, happy. Stay connected with me on my yoga page, on my YouTube channel. Connect with me if you have any questions, please do let me know. Please visit Mumbai, of course. I will be coming to Mumbai very soon. And definitely, I will be meeting all of you personally, the Mumbai office people. And thank you so much to Mr. Nilesh Nikalje, who has organized this entire effort. And to Ms. Bina Benin. Bina, who has been really helpful, and thank you so much for all the coordinations and for keeping all of you fit and healthy and positive during this very, very unique situation. So take care
thank
of
you, Ankita.
And
thank you, lots of
love to all the kiddos who were participating in the session. It was really so nice to see all of you doing the, you know, practice. So thank you, especially I've seen the daughter of Mrs. Nagarajan. So thank you and you take care. And I've seen daughter of Sadhana ji. So love to her. And I've also seen two little ones, I think, with Mr.
Yeah, today we could not see him. Huh? There are all of these two chotus will come on the screen with him.
Yes, here she is. What's your name? क्या नाम है आपका
बोलो
आइजल
हाँ
आइजल
आइजल
आइजल ओके एंड व्हाट अबाउट यू मिसेस नागराजन्स डॉटर हाँ अनम्यूट
निरामय
And yes, I can see this with Miss Aruna. That's so cute. I am really
so I request all the participants to give a feedback. I have posted the link, the Google link on the chat. So we would request all of you all that you all have enjoyed the last 7 series and had a wonderful experience. So I request all of you all to post your feedback on the Google link, which I have posted on the chat.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, Bina.
Thank you so much. Take care, everyone.
Thank you, Rajesh.
Stay happy, stay positive. Thank you. Namaste, everyone. God bless you.
Thank you. Namaste, Ankita.
Great having my solution. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Indian Oil also. Thank you, ma'am, for arranging such a beautiful
thing. Ms. Bina. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. Namaste.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Namaste.
Thank you.